Hi, Hemant. How are you?
I'm good, sir.
Okay, so what was your score in the last mock papers? Can I know that?
Sir, yesterday only I attempted a mock for the championship test.
Yes. In the championship test, I want to know your score.
Sir, I have attempted all the three championship tests. In the first one, I got 109.
109 marks?
Yes, sir.
Okay, and in your second mock paper, what was your score?
In the second, I got 131, sir.
131. And in third?
In third, I got 93.
You got 93. Okay. Eman, can you also tell me in third your score was lowest, right? So
yes,
your score increased from 109 to 131 and then it decreased to 93. Do you have your individual section score right now? Can you just give me an idea? When you got 131 marks, what was your individual score in Quant, LR, and DI? Quant, LR, DI, and Verbal?
So in Verbal, it was 59.
59 was in Verbal, okay. Yes. And in LRDI?
And at once in LRDI, I think it was both 30 to 33.
30 to 33, all right.
Yes, sir.
And what was your score in Quant?
33,
okay. And when you got 93 in the third mock, what was your score in Verbal Ability?
In Verbal, it was 51.
Okay. And in LRDI?
It was 12.
12, okay. And in Quant?
30.
And also in the first mock, give me an idea on Verbal Ability.
The first mock, roughly it was 41, 30, 30.
Verbal Ability, 41.
Yes, sir.
And LRDI, the score was?
30, around 30.
Okay. Got it. I got a fair idea. What are your strength areas and weak areas? So you see that if you analyze your scorecard of three mock papers that you have given till now, I can consistently see. I can see that you are consistently performing in verbal ability.
Yes,
so I can see that your verbal ability is a strength area. Can I say that?
Yes, sir.
So I guess it's gradually improving. 15 to 20 questions. Right now, I can see that you're doing 15 to 20 questions correct in your verbal ability.
Yes, sir.
And what are the number of questions that you're attempting?
So in verbal, it's around 23 to 24.
So 23 to 24 you are attempting and you are able to correct around 15 to 20, right? So
yes.
This is a accuracy of 80%, correct?
Yes.
Right. So I can see the verbal ability. I don't think that you have any issue with it, right? All you have to do is just work on your accuracy and your score automatically can jump to up to 60 marks. Can we say that? Even if you just work on accuracy, right? So if one thing that I would like to suggest in verbal ability is that I'm not saying that you should go with this strategy in the final mock paper, just to test yourself, right? Give two or three mock papers where you increase your number of attempts to 30, right? Because as you can see that right now you are saying that you are attempting 23 to 25 questions.
Yes.
And your accuracy is around 80%.
Yes.
Let's say even if you maintained our accuracy at 80% only, but if I increase my number of questions, by the number of questions that I'm attempting by 5 to 8 questions, that will give me approximately four new correct questions, and that will improve your score by 12 marks, right? Even if you don't work on the accuracy, if you just increase the number of attempts, right? And you maintain the accuracy at 80%, your score can jump by 10 marks in verbal ability, right? Okay, so now this might work and it might not work also, right? It depends. You'll have to check it by attempting two or three mock papers. Let's see whether this strategy works or not. Because all those mistakes that we are supposed to do before the final mock paper, it has to be done before a final, right?
Definitely,
mocks are for your learning and to finalize your strategy, that what is the strategy that you will finally be going with. Right, in the final CAT exam, right?
Yes, yes.
So in verbal ability, I would like to suggest looking at your score that let's try this on a trial basis, right? Whether by improving the attempts, whether our scores improve or not. If it does not improve, then we will try to work on accuracy. कि आपको accuracy कैसे improve करना है, फिर हम उस पे देखेंगे, right? कहाँ आपके weak areas हैं? I will also suggest कि verbal ability में एक proper आप analysis करो अपने तीनों mock papers में. कि नंबर ऑफ क्वेश्चन जो आपने गलत किए उनके रीजंस क्या थे, वेदर इट वाज अ रॉन्ग अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ द स्टेटमेंट, या फिर आपका वोकैबुलरी का कोई वर्ड आपको समझ में नहीं आया उसकी वजह से आपने आरसी का कोई क्वेश्चन गलत किया, और नंबर ऑफ क्वेश्चन जो आपने गलत किए वो आरसी में थे या सेंटेंस रीअरेंजमेंट में थे या क्रिटिकल रीजनिंग में थे, राइट? So exactly. Agar aap regularly critical reasoning mein kar rahe ho, that means aapka critical reasoning part is weak. Can you just give me an idea verbal kis part mein aap marks lose kar rahe ho?
Sir, actually main verbal ability mein zyada attempt hi nahi karta hu. I attempt only the RCs and verbal ability 3-4 questions.
Okay, okay.
So 8 questions I directly leave the verbal ability part. That's why I think the I need to attend more
questions. I don't think that it would be wrong to follow the same strategy in CAT also, because major part of CAT is made of reading comprehension, right? I also sometimes back, you know, I talked with one of the CAT 2019 topper. I took a chamomile interview with that topper, and he got 99.99 in CAT 2019. So he also followed the same strategy. He never, you know, used to attempt this verbal ability section. He was going only with the reading comprehension. And he was able to score 99%+. But his accuracy in reading comprehension part was 98-95%, you know, approximately almost 100%. So he attempted around 21 questions in CAT 2019 and only one question was wrong. So I would not say, we can work on RC also, right? In your case also, we can, you know, go with the only RC attempt, because if you are observing that your accuracy in verbal ability part is less, so we can also, you know, go with the only RC part. Right. If you are done with the RC in 15 minutes, then in 10 minutes, you might attempt one or two questions of verbal ability. But you have to check whether this works in your case, whether you are able to get, you know, if you are attempting 21 questions, whether you can get 20 questions correct in your case or not. Right. If that start happening in the mock paper, then in the final mock paper, I would say that you go with the RC only first. Your first priority should be to attempt the RCs. Right. Don't attempt verbal ability unless your RC time is over or RC set are over, right? So I guess you get a fair idea, right? Verbal ability, you have, the way you need to attempt the next paper.
Yes, sir.
Isme jyada,
I'll try out the strategy and let's see what works out for me.
Right. So verbal ability part is done, right? You get to know kaise aapko verbal ability mein aage deal karna hai. And also try to see ki aapke agar sentence rearrangement or critical reasoning mein agar कुछ क्वेश्चन जैसे क्रिटिकल रीजनिंग में ऐसे होते हैं ना, जिसमें लास्ट क्वेश्चन आप पैराग्राफ दिया हुआ, आपको बताना है कि यार लास्ट पैराग्राफ की लाइन क्या होगी, है ना, व्हाट विल बी द लास्ट लाइन व्हिच विल सूट, उनमें हमेशा एक्यूरेसी इतना अच्छा नहीं हो सकता है. एक्यूरेसी में हमेशा उस वो क्वेश्चन को सही करना इतना ईजी नहीं है. इट्स नॉट ईजी टू डू दीज टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन करेक्ट. हो सकता है क्रिटिकल रीजनिंग में भी कुछ ऐसा सेक्शन हो, कुछ ऐसे क्वेश्चन क्रिटिकल रीजनिंग के जो इजी से इजीली आप अटेम्प्ट कर सकते हैं ना. हर सेक्शन में डिफरेंट सब सेक्शंस होते हैं. सो क्रिटिकल रीजनिंग में कुछ ऐसे क्वेश्चन होंगे जिसमें आपको लाइन लास्ट लाइन बतानी है. देयर वुड बी सम क्वेश्चन जिसमें आपको यू नो यू आर सपोज्ड टू फाइंड आउट द स्टेटमेंट व्हिच विल स्ट्रेंथन द आर्ग्यूमेंट्स ऑफ द ऑथर, दैट विल वीकन द आर्ग्यूमेंट्स ऑफ द ऑथर, राइट? सो ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट कि क्या क्रिटिकल रीजनिंग में ऐसे एक या दो सब सेक्शन है जिसमें आपका एक्यूरेसी 100% आ सकता है, बिकॉज उसमें भी आप एक दो क्वेश्चन लेके आ सकते हो अपने अपने जोन के अंदर. एंड देन यू गेट यू नो टू क्वेश्चंस इज लाइक 8 मार्क्स, राइट? क्वेश्चन है बट आप गलत कर रहे हो तो उसका नेगेटिव ऐड करें तो आपका स्कोर 6-7-8 मार्क्स इंप्रूव हो सकता है अगर आप एक या दो सब सेक्शन पे काम करो. वी विल गो विद दिस कि हाँ वर्बल एबिलिटी नहीं करना है, बट जो वर्बल एबिलिटी पार्ट आप लीव कर रहे हो उसमें कौन से यू नो सब सेक्शन ऐसे हैं जहां पे आप इंप्रूवमेंट लेके आ सकते हो, या फिर जो जिसका कॉन्सेप्ट आरसी से ही कनेक्ट. क्योंकि अभी आप क्या है कि बिल्कुल बेंच ऐसे पॉइंट्स पे हो कि आपको सिर्फ वर्बल एबिलिटी में आपको 60 तक जंप करना है, लेट्स से, या 60-65 तक जंप करना है, तो 8-10 का इंप्रूवमेंट आपको चाहिए. 59 मार्क्स आप ऑलरेडी एक बार वर्बल एबिलिटी में ला चुके हो, 51 भी आपने लेके आया, राइट? तो आई जस्ट नीड एन इंप्रूवमेंट ऑफ 10-15 मार्क्स. तो मेरे को ऐसे कहीं सेक्शन में यू नो 2-3 क्वेश्चन देखने पड़ेंगे जहां पे मेरा इंप्रूव हो सके, राइट? यू जस्ट नीड 2-3 more 4 more क्वेश्चन इन वर्बल एबिलिटी एंड योर इन वर्बल एबिलिटी विल बी डन, आई गेस, राइट?
Yes, sir.
And now coming to LRDI and quant section, which is my expert area.
So yes, sir. मैं आपके videos अभी देखना start किया.
Okay.
The previous algebra videos I have started watching now of modulus and all. That's why I'm clearing the concepts a little bit and let's see what follows.
Okay. And what about arithmetic and all?
Arithmetic is done, sir. Arithmetic is done, and I don't face lot of issues in arithmetic. Number of practice questions also have covered almost each area, but geometry I have never touched geometry, and I hate it. That's why geometry.
So let's first talk about quant then. What I would like to guide you here in term for quant is, see Vishnu, what are the number of questions that will be coming across in quant? 34. Yes,
sir.
And currently, I see that your score that you are getting is around 30 marks. So you are able to get around 10 questions correct. Right? How's that 10 to 12 up questions? I karo, usme do din aap kuch galat bhi kar rahe honge. So see, quant mein kya rehta hai? If you look at the previous year paper of quant section of CAT exam, you will see that there are easy questions and there are difficult questions also. Right? And just give me a fair idea. I just want to know whether you know this thing or not. Out of 34 questions in quant, if you want to get 99 plus percentile, what is the marks that you should be targeting? Kitne marks
70 to 75, sir?
Yes, 70 marks. 70 is safe for 10. 70 marks if you're getting in quant, it's a close deal for 99.99 percentile, right? I have never seen, in 2017, quant was very easy. Way easier than any other CAT paper in the history of CAT. 2017 में quant सबसे ज़्यादा easy था, वो बहुत ही basic questions. अब ये time and work के ऐसे questions भी हैं जो जिससे time and work का chapter शुरू होता है. और वो question उन्होंने CAT 2018 में पूछे. 17. उस paper में भी I remember on 69 marks the percentile wise was around 99, right? So 69 में इतने easy paper में भी 23 questions पे आपका 99 plus percentile. I don't remember exact, but the percentile was at exactly 99.96 at 76 mark, right? 99.96 percentile at 76 marks. Right? So again, easy paper mein bhi agar 25 questions pe aapka 99.9 plus percentile ja raha hai. So agar main moderate level of paper ki baat karu, if you talk about CAT 2018 or 19, jo moderate level mein aate hain, bahut zyada, even 2018 was considered to be the toughest CAT paper in the history of CAT in terms of quant, which is actually not. It's just a statement of the different institutions. However, if you look at the questions, you know, every question is from your syllabus. I don't know why they are calling it a difficult, but yes, even if, you know, jo bhi unhone survey kiya, bachcho ko difficult laga, right? Usme bhi cutoff jo tha 20 to 23 question.
For 99?
In 2018. So 60, 65 marks, 99 percentile. The level they go easy se toughest gaya. 2017 mein sabse easiest or 2018 mein toughest, and still the cutoff marks get reduced by only 5 to 6 marks, right? So we can fairly say that yes, 65 to 75 marks, if you are in any range in quant, that's a close deal for 99.9 plus percent. 99.9 or 99.7 aa jayega ya 99.6 aa jayega right yes so we can say that ki mere ko 25 question target karne hai let's say quant kya yes sir 25 questions mere ko target karne hai total number of questions and 34 right now you have the options of leaving 9 questions any day you can leave 9 questions right 9 questions no problem is the 9 questions that you are supposed to leave that you want to leave those 9 questions has to be in from your weak areas. Every student has his strength and weak areas, right? If I am attempting CAT, I might leave the 9 questions from my weak areas, right? My weak areas can be different from your weak areas, right? Your strength areas will be different, right? So it's very, very important. First thing, ki aapko aapke strength or weak areas pata hone chahiye. When it's say strength or weak areas, kya iska ye meaning nahi hai ki geometry mera weak area, so I'll be leaving geometry. Because then you will not be able to reach an attempt of 25 questions. Because out of 34 questions, agar mere ko arithmetic mein, let's say, I'm getting 15 questions. Do you think pura arithmetic ko easy dal denge? Nahi dalenge.
They always obviously.
So out of 15 questions, there will be, you know, there will be 10 easy to moderate questions, and there can be 4 to 5 difficult questions. Now a difficult question is a difficult. It will be difficult for me as well. It will be difficult for you. If I'm attempting a difficult question, it increases the timing of the solution. Right? Yes. Mera time jo hai, jo questions ko attempt karne ka time hai, wo 2 minutes se 4 minutes ya 5 minutes pe chala jayega. So, if my time 4 minutes, 5 minutes, pe ja raha hai, and let's say ki I'm picking 6 difficult questions in the paper to attempt. So, mere ko ye 6 questions ko attempt karne mein kitne minutes? 24, 25 minutes gaye. So, is it possible to attempt 25 questions then? Nahi ho payega. So, fir aapke easy questions will leave karenge, right? So, quant, see, even if you know the 100% math, still if you follow the wrong strategy in the paper, it's not possible to get 99.99%, right? 99.99 percentile mein sirf aapka quant ka knowledge nahi important matter karta, uske saath aapka selection of questions bhi matter karta. Aur selection of questions can only go right if you know ki geometry mein kis type ka question mujhse hone wala hai, kis type ka question mujhse nahi hone wala hai. Arithmetic mein kaun se type ka question mujhe karna hai aur kaun se type ka question mujhe leave karna hai, because wahan pe aapne arithmetic kar rakha hai, suppose bahut acche se kar rakha hai, बट अगर वहां पे क्वेश्चन ही डिफिकल्ट आ गया अरिथमेटिक का और आपने उसमें 7 to 8 minutes वेस्ट कर दिए तो फिर बताओ आपको सिक्सटी मिनट लिमिटेड टाइम है. आपको वहां पे ये फाइंड नहीं करना है कि मेरे को अरिथमेटिक किया है, ईगो पे नहीं लेना है कि मेरे को तो करना ही करना है अरिथमेटिक है क्योंकि अरिथमेटिक तो मैंने किया ही है. मैंने भी ज्योमेट्री बहुत अच्छे से किया और मैंने अपने ज्योमेट्री के कोर्स में ऑन अनअकैडमी प्लस बच्चों को 500 प्लस क्वेश्चंस प्रैक्टिस करवाया है विद 150 प्लस प्रॉपर्टीज एंड आई हैव डिस्कस द प्रूफ ऑफ एवरी प्रॉपर्टी. इट डजंट मीन that if I'm sitting in the CAT paper for geometry questions, I'll be able to attempt 7 out of 7 questions. No, I can't. There would be 1 or 2 questions. Because if I go for all 7 out of 7 questions, then my total number of attempts will never reach 25. Because they are bound to be some difficult questions. Wo har section mein se aapko easy difficult hai. So quant ke liye, the strategy that I would like to tell you that you should follow, ki aapko syllabus ek pura karna hai, right? There should not be a single chapter that you should be leaving. जैसे आप बोल रहे हो कि आपने ज्योमेट्री नहीं किया.
ज्योमेट्री नहीं किया सर, अभी तक नहीं किया.
नहीं नहीं, ज्योमेट्री करना पड़ेगा. रीजन इज आपने अरिथमेटिक कर लिया. अरिथमेटिक के डिफिकल्ट क्वेश्चंस विल टेक यू डाउन बाय 20 मिनट्स, राइट? और उसी टाइम पे आप ज्योमेट्री के 4 क्वेश्चन इजी वाले कर सकते हो, 3 डिफिकल्ट छोड़ दो, राइट? सो इफ देयर आर 7 ज्योमेट्री क्वेश्चंस दे आर आस्किंग, बिकॉज पिछले 5-6 ईयर्स का अगर आप पेपर देखोगे विल फाइंड कि दे आर आस्किंग 7 to 8 क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम ज्योमेट्री. सर्कल के अंदर एक रेक्टेंगल बना हुआ है. रेक्टेंगल का वन साइड इज नो उसमें दिया हुआ था, एक ट्रिपलेट बन रहा था, दो साइड दी हुई थी. इट वॉज द क्वेश्चन वॉज लाइक 5, एक साइड 5 है, एक साइड 10 है, तो थर्ड उसका डायमीटर क्या होगा, तो वो ट्रिपलेट आपको लगाना था, राइट? जो भी ट्रिपलेट पे, बिल्कुल सिंपलेस्ट ट्रिपलेट पे क्वेश्चन था. और साथ में एक क्वेश्चन ऐसा भी था जो बहुत डिफिकल्ट था, राइट? कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री का. बट अगर मैं, ठीक है, जो डिफिकल्ट, अगर मैंने ज्योमेट्री नहीं किया वो डिफिकल्ट क्वेश्चन तो मैं लीक करूंगा, बट अगर मैंने ज्योमेट्री नहीं करके जाता तो एक ट्रिपलेट बेस्ड क्वेश्चन जो कि एक सेकंड में हो सकता है वो भी मैं लीक करता
हूँ. right?
वो नहीं करना है आपको, राइट? आई लेट मी टेल यू द एग्जैक्ट क्वेश्चन क्या था. वो उसमें रेक्टेंगल का लेंथ जो था वो 24 दिया हुआ था, विड्थ जो था वो 10 था. यू कैन क्रॉस चेक इट, इट इज आपके पास 2017-18-19 के क्वेश्चन होंगे. और डायमीटर का लेंथ बताना था. सो
10, 24, 10, 24, 25, 26
बनेगा. 100 plus 576, द डायमीटर विल बी 676, so square root of 674, 26. तो इतना सा क्वेश्चन उन्होंने पूछा. अब बताओ ये क्वेश्चंस, ये क्वेश्चन अगर कोई बच्चा लीव करता है तो कभी बच्चे 25 के अटेम्प्ट पे पहुंच पाएगा? ये क्वेश्चन को लीव करके आप उसके सामने लेट्स से कि टाइम एंड वर्क का कोई डिफिकल्ट क्वेश्चन या टाइम स्पीड डिस्टेंस का कोई डिफिकल्ट क्वेश्चन, जो बच्चा ये वाला क्वेश्चन करेगा वो 10 सेकंड में 20 सेकंड में आगे जाएगा, राइट? और नया क्वेश्चन उठाएगा और आप 5 मिनट एक ही क्वेश्चन पे लगा रहे. सो इट्स वेरी, yes, selection of question plays a very important role with 100% syllabus coverage. Geometry aapka weak hai. Let's not accept this as a fact right now because you still have a lot of time and you can improve on it.
Yes,
so what I would suggest, go for the areas that you have not covered yet. Complete it, right? And when you are selecting the questions, try to select easy question from every chapter. Aap dekho, abhi aapka score 30 hai na. Aap geometry achche se kar lo. राइट, चलो अगर मॉडरेट लेवल पे भी करते 500 क्वेश्चंस नहीं करते, अब बेसिक प्रॉपर्टीज सारे ट्रिपलेट्स हो गए, ट्रायंगल की प्रॉपर्टीज होगी, इन सेंटर सर्कम सेंटर, ये सब बेसिक प्रॉपर्टीज दैट से कि आप कवर. और 7 में से 8 में से क्वेश्चंस अगर आप 4 क्वेश्चंस भी करो, आई एम सेइंग दैट ओनली अटेम्प्ट 50% क्वेश्चन ऑफ चुका, आपका स्कोर ऑटोमेटिक 16 मार्क्स 12 मार्क्स इंप्रूव हो गया 30 से.
तो आपके प्लस में जो आपकी कोर्स है सर 43 लेसंस है उसमें, इज दैट सफिशिएंट? यू से कम
मोर देन सफिशिएंट, इट वुड बी मोर देन सफिशिएंट. 500 प्लस क्वेश्चंस हैं, आई डोंट थिंक कि उसमें कोई क्वेश्चन आपका बाहर रह जाएगा किसी भी टाइप का. 150 प्लस प्रॉपर्टीज विद प्रूफ्स, आई हैव डिस्कस इट.
अभी तो अल्जेब्रा कर रहा हूं, अल्जेब्रा पूरा कंप्लीट करता हूं उसके बाद.
ओके, अल्जेब्रा में भी यू विल फाइंड 500 प्लस क्वेश्चंस. सो
नहीं, अल्जेब्रा वाज रियली गुड सर. पहले तो मैं पहले लंबे लंबे प्रोसेस से करता था, बट आफ्टर वॉचिंग योर लेसंस खाली वैल्यूज पुट कर रहा हूं और आंसर आ जाता है.
Alright, good, good. वो tricks भी आने, वो starting के 3 lesson में मैंने वही discuss किया. Alright, so whatever you know the chapters that you have not covered, आपने I guess आपका marks कम इसलिए आ रहा है क्योंकि आपने अभी तक सिर्फ arithmetic किया है, है ना? I can see.
Arithmetic, modern maths किया sir, और algebra भी किया हुआ, but comprehensively नहीं किया, तो धीरे-धीरे cover कर रहा
हूँ. ठीक है, तो arithmetic में इसलिए I can see कि quant का score कम इसलिए है. Arithmetic में you are attempting questions, right? और अरिथमेटिक के डिफिकल्ट क्वेश्चन में आपको टाइम ज्यादा लग रहा है तो आपका इसलिए ओवरऑल 10 to 12 के बीच में रह रहा है. अरिथमेटिक में आपको 15 क्वेश्चंस है, आप टारगेट करना है कि 10 टू 12 क्वेश्चंस. अगर सब इजी आते हैं तो सारे करो, कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं. बट हाँ, बट ऑलवेज कीप दैट साइड ओपन कि हाँ अरिथमेटिक भले मैंने किया है बट अगर मुझे वहां पे डिफिकल्ट कोई क्वेश्चन मिलता तो आई विल बी लीविंग दैट क्वेश्चन एंड इंस्टेड आई विल पिकिंग अ इजी क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम अलजेब्रा एंड ज्योमेट्री. एंड बिकॉज अभी देखो आपका आपके नंबर ऑफ अटेम्प्ट्स कितना इंप्रूव हो जाएंगे अगर आपका अलजेब्रा भी आपकी किटी में आ गया एंड यू ऑल्सो हैव अ ज्योमेट्री राइट. सो you have a range of, you know, you'll have 14 more questions out of which you will be attempting some more questions. So 14 mein I'm saying ki agar aap 7 bhi sahi karte to still that improve your score by 21 marks.
20 marks, right?
So aap 50-50 pe aram se ja sakte ho, apna score quantitative aptitude mein 50 pe leke ja sakte, right? 60 wahan pe aa raha hai aapka, 50-55 mein yahan pe aa raha hai, 110 reh gaya abhi LRDI section.
LRDI.
What is the problem? LRDI, I can see that you are only LRDI mein, in the last mock paper you attend only you get only 12 marks. Huh?
It's quite bad. -9 ho gaya sir. Actually, I attempted, I scored 21 but due to negative marking and wrong selection of sets, that's why I scored.
See, LRDI, I would say, LRDI mein kuch theory hai nahi. DI mein bahut basic theory hai. Mostly it's connected with quant. Percentage ho gaya, ratio ho gaya, right? Average ho gaya, right? So all this theory part of data interpretation is will be covered in quant automatically, right? Thode bahut growth percentage ke concepts hain, DI ke specifically a data comparison hai, right? Jo alag se aapko learn karne padenge when it comes to DI specifically, ya fir charts ko read kaise karna hai. And LR mein koi theory nahi hai. Right, so it's not that ki aapne football tournament ka set kar liya to aapko football tournament as it is wahi mil jayega. Nahi, वो तो पूरा स्टेटमेंट बेस्ड ही है, राइट? इंस्ट्रक्शंस बेस्ड ही है, इट्स कंप्लीटली बेस्ड ऑन योर रीडिंग स्किल्स, राइट? आप प्रॉपरली इंस्ट्रक्शंस कैसे फॉलो करते हो, डेटा को कैसे ऑर्गेनाइज करते हो, इट्स ओनली द प्रैक्टिस, राइट? नाउ व्हाट आई वुड लाइक, सिलेक्शन ऑफ सेट आपका गलत जा रहा है, आई कैन सी, राइट? एंड दैट्स व्हाई आई एम श्योर कि आपने एक बेसिक सेट तो सेलेक्ट किया होगा.
लेंथी सेट्स देखते ही छोड़ देता हूं, भले ही वो इजी हो सर. कल गेम्स एंड टूर्नामेंट पे एक सेट था सर, वो देखते ही छोड़ दिया, बाद में देखा कि बहुत इजी था.
Both easy though. Okay. So I guess your selection of question in LRDI is going wrong, right? So let's improve karenge. Aisa to nahi hai ki I would say ki hum 12 pe seedha 50 pe jump kar sakte hain, right? So let's try to jump from 12 to 30 and then 30 to 40 and then 40 to 50. Is tarah se aap improve kar sakte hain. One thing that I would like to suggest in LRDI section is that while you're practicing the LRDI section, what you should do is, Hemant, don't go for, you know, while practicing, don't just pick one set and attempt it. What you do is, whenever you're sitting for your LRDI next time, take 8 set, okay? The way you will be getting in the CAT exam, right? Because selection of set is a habit. It does not come in one day, okay? Yes, din ke andar aapka wo selection improve nahi ho sakta. Do din mein bhi nahi ho sakta, right? In fact, I would say ke 10 din mein bhi nahi ho sakta. Selection of set sahi jaane ke liye, you will have to practice, right? Selection of set ka bhi practice kaise karna hai? You will be giving a one sectional test. Every time you are sitting for your LRDI, you will take, aapne 8 set dekhne hai ki haan, aaj main ye 8 set attempt karne wala hu. Set a clock for 60 minutes. And every time you are sitting for LRDI practice, you first attempt 8 set the way you will be attempting the LRDI section final CAT. And try to maximize your score. From day one, start learning the selection process. And then find out why your selection is going wrong. For example, now I can say that you said, I left one set because it was lengthy, but however it was quite easy, right? Yes, so this is a one, you know, you get to know about one weakness of yours, that this is the point where you are doing the mistakes, that you're not going on the reading, you're just going with the length of the paragraph.
Actually, it happens in quants also. If there's a question from arithmetic but it's quite long, then I leave it.
Okay.
Especially on the fact that the question is
okay. So if there's a lengthy statement that confuses you, right? That confuses
yes.
कि आप वो आप सारा कनेक्ट. सो व्हाट यू शुड डू इज कि लेंथी अगर कुछ पैराग्राफ है, 2 मिनट आप प्रॉपरली इसको रीड करो एंड जस्ट ट्राई टू, यू नो, मेक अ स्मॉल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ इट कि आपको बार बार इन्फॉर्मेशन रीड नहीं करना पड़े. सी, इफ आई हैव 10 लाइंस रिटन इन फ्रंट ऑफ मी ऑन अ नोटबुक, राइट, लेट्स से किसी भी लॉजिकल रीजनिंग है, मैं पहली लाइन से 10th लाइन तक पहुंचूंगा, तब तक तो मेरा फर्स्ट लाइन सेकंड लाइन पे जो मेरा कंटेंट होगा माइंड में, इट विल बी गॉन, बिकॉज़ इट्स नॉट वर्बल एबिलिटीज, लॉजिकल रीजनिंग, राइट? तो उसमें कंटेंट होगा, डेटा होगा, है ना, उसमें नेम्स होंगे, राइट? वो तो ऐसा तो नहीं है कि वो पूरा एक ही कॉन्टेक्स्ट में किसी जैसे पैराग्राफ कुछ पढ़ रहे हैं, अगर मैं स्टीव जॉब का बायोग्राफी पढ़ रहा हूँ या किसी भी इकोनॉमिक पे कुछ पैराग्राफ पढ़ रहा हूँ, तो इकोनॉमिक सेंस में
अलग अलग डेटा होगा,
वो इमेज बनता जाता है माइंड में, राइट? बट इट्स एलआर दैट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट. सो व्हेनेवर यू आर अटेम्प्टिंग द एलआर, सो व्हाट यू डू इज यू स्टार्ट रीडिंग द पैराग्राफ, यू रीडिंग अ लेंथी पैराग्राफ, जस्ट डोंट रीड इट, राइट? व्हाट यू डू इज मेक अ स्मॉल स्ट्रक्चर ऑन इट इन योर नोट, राइट? जैसे एक लाइन पर जैसे नेम्स लिखे, राइट? जो भी नेम्स हैं उनको शॉर्ट फॉर्म में लिखा, एंड देन यू make a small structure ki kiske bare mein kaun sa information kise kaise connected. So after reading 7 to 8 lines, you look at your structure that you have made and try to see, is this set familiar with what you have practiced earlier? Is the kind of set, is there any statement that you are not able to understand, that you are not able to understand? Let's say there is a statement in a paragraph jisko aapke bare mein aapko samajh hi nahi aa raha, so there is no point of attempting that set, right? However, agar aapne LR pura structure bana liya aur aapko aisa bhi confirm hai ki ye arrangement se related set hai, या फिर स्ट्रीट नेटवर्क का कुछ सेट है या रूट्स एंड नेटवर्क से रिलेटेड है, और उसमें ऐसी कोई स्टेटमेंट भी नहीं है जो मेरे को कंफ्यूज कर रही है, यू शुड डेफिनेटली गिव इट एज एन अटेम्प्ट. आपको 10 मिनट उस पर लगाने चाहिए, 7 to 8 मिनट्स आपको उस पर लगाने चाहिए, आपका सेट सॉल्व हो जाएगा, डेफिनेटली हो जाएगा, राइट? और वन मोर थिंग दैट आई वुड लाइक टू से इज एलआरडीआई इज ऑल अबाउट कॉन्फिडेंस, लेट मी टेल यू. टू बी वेरी फ्रैंक, 17, 18, 19 टिल नाउ, कैट के पेपर्स की बात कर रहा हूँ, एक दो सेट को छोड़ के कोई भी एक ऐसा सेट भी नहीं है पेपर में जो टाइम लिमिट में सॉल्व नहीं हो सकता. सिर्फ वन और टू सेट की हम 17 के डीआई देख लो, 2017 वाज कंसीडर्ड एज अ टफेस्ट एलआरडीआई सेक्शन.
यस सर,
है ना? 17 का क्वांट सबसे इजी था, लेकिन एलआरडीआई सबसे डिफिकल्ट
था.
अभी एलआरडीआई 17 में क्वीन वाला सेट था, 5 मिनट से ज्यादा का टाइम नहीं लगता है उस क्वीन से. क्वीन वाले वो जो चेस, जिसने बेसिक चेस भी खेली हो वो भी उसको अटेम्प्ट कर सकता है, राइट? एक दूसरा सेट था प्लेटफॉर्म पे हाइट कंपैरिजन वाला, वो भी इतना बेसिक सेट है कि आपको 7-8 मिनट्स भी नहीं लगे. एक बर्गर वाला था, बहुत बेसिक सेट था. व्हाई 2017 इज कंसीडर्ड टू बी द टफेस्ट एलआरडीए सेक्शन टिल डेट, बिकॉज देयर वर 2 to 3 सेट व्हिच वर रियली रियली डिफिकल्ट. वन वाज ऑफ सेट थ्योरी, जो ये AIM BIM वाला सेट था ना, वो जो नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स जिनका परसेंटाइल वाला
सेट था, पहला ही सेट था सर,
हां वो बहुत डिफिकल्ट था, वो पेपर में नहीं हो सकता था. एक दूसरे जो सेट थे वो एमडा वाला और क्याला वाला, जिसमें वो फ्रीक्वेंसी पे आया था, वो नया टाइप का सेट था, बट वो डिफिकल्ट नहीं था. तो उसमें सिर्फ 2017 को डिफिकल्ट इसलिए बोला गया बिकॉज दे वर 2 to 3 सेट जो बच्चा टच भी नहीं कर सकता एग्जाम के, बट बाकी के 5-6 सेट के बारे में बात करें, वो तो 5-5, 7-7 मिनट के सेट थे, वो बिल्कुल भी डिफिकल्ट नहीं थे. सो इफ आई लुक एट द 5 सेट द पेपर इज इजी फॉर मी, बट इफ आई लुक दोस 3 सेट द पेपर इज डिफिकल्ट फॉर मी. So it's completely dependent कि आपने attempt easy किया difficult के लिए. CAT is difficult for those students who are attempting difficult questions. But CAT is easy for those students which is attempting easy questions, right?
Yes, sir. Difficult questions में कल फंस गया था sir.
I attempted
wrong question.
आपको difficult questions CAT में मिलेंगे, but difficult question will take you to IIMS. Difficult question will get you 99.9 plus. No, they cannot do, right? Only questions from your strength areas. Questions which are easy to moderate level, which can be solved in time limit, will take you to 99.9, right? So selection of strategy, selection of questions is a very important part when it comes to CAT. It's not only your knowledge, it's also the major strategy as per your strength and weak areas, right? That you will be following in the CAT exam. Now, when it comes to selection of question, it cannot come in one single day. It has to be a habit, right? और सिर्फ mock paper आप ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा कितने दे दोगे? 20 mock papers दे दोगे?
30 और दे दूँगा हाँ sir. हाँ sir.
तो 20-30 से नहीं आने वाला. So whenever you are sitting for it, try to go for sectional test. जैसे अभी Unacademy app के ऊपर एक नया option आया that there's a live quiz which every educator is taking.
Yes sir. Right?
And there उसमें सबसे अच्छा feature ये है कि every question has a set of time. क्वेश्चन लीव करो जो आपको लग रहा है कि यार ये नहीं हो.
आई
शेयर द टाइमिंग विद यू. एवरी डे आई एम राइट नाउ आई एम टेकिंग एट 12:05 आई एम टेकिंग अ अरिथमेटिक क्विज. And at 4 p.m. I will be starting an LRDI quiz in the coming
weeks. Sir.
I'll be updating it in my Telegram group, right? You can join my Telegram group, right?
No, I'm in your Telegram.
So I keep on uploading the code there and then you can attempt. Okay. So usme aapko benefit ye milega that your selection of questions will automatically, aapko pata lagega ki mereko ye questions karna hai ya nahi karna. Because abhi main suppose karo book utha liya maine, koi bhi book utha liya, koi bhi worksheet utha liya, and if I start attempting the questions, will attempting that questions give anything on the selection strategy? आप क्वेश्चन अटेम्प्ट करो, नहीं आएगा, सोल्यूशन देखोगे, डिस्कस करोगे एजुकेटर के साथ, राइट? सिलेक्शन ऑफ क्वेश्चंस तब होगा जब आपके सामने क्लॉक होगा 60 मिनट का, एंड यू हैव अ फिक्स सेट ऑफ क्वेश्चंस जिसमें से आपको मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ वही क्वेश्चंस करने हैं जो आपके स्ट्रेंथ एरियाज हैं, राइट? सो यू नीड टू प्रैक्टिस द सिलेक्शन ऑफ क्वेश्चंस इन एवरी डे व्हेन इट कम्स टू एलआरडी एंड व्हेन इट कम्स टू क्वांट आल्सो. इवन आई वुड से इफ यू आर गोइंग फॉर आरसी प्रैक्टिस, डोंट गो फॉर वन और टू आरसीज डेली, राइट? पिक अ सेट ऑफ 8 आरसीज, sit for 60 minutes, attempt those answers, select, right? Start selecting it. And if it goes wrong, then analyze it. Ki maine galat, maine ye wala set RC kyun nahi kiya, ye wala kyun nahi kiya, right? So, agar aap daily is tarah se practice karoge, you know, it comes into your habit, aapko habit ho jayegi ki haan mere ko, aapko exactly aapke wo points pata lagenge ki kahan main kahan galti kar raha hu selections mein. Jaise aapki ek galti yahan pe abhi aapne khud nahi bataya ki lengthy set ko dekh ke aap
likhe. Yes, sir.
So, that automatically gets improved there. Right? So daily आपको selection का भी practice करना है, सिर्फ quant का practice नहीं करना है, right? So don't forget, CAT is not made of 3 subjects, right? Quant, LIDI and verbal ability, right? So there's 1/4 thing that you need to prepare yourself is your confidence, your calming mind, right? With the attitude with which you will be sitting in the paper, right? If somebody is going for the first time in the CAT exam, you will definitely, you know, have fear in the mind. You need to prepare yourself for that stage. How to be fearless at that point? उस दिन कैसे मेरे को fearlessly paper attempt करना है? वो तब होगा जब आपने आपको pressurize करना शुरू करो.
Exactly.
So start pressurizing yourself when it comes to a time section. Time limit में questions को attempt करोगे तो आपका automatically pressure mind में, pressure situation में आपका mind कैसे react करता है आपको उसका बारे में पता लगेगा. Right? तो pressure situation में आप ढंग से perform करते हो या नहीं करते हो? अगर नहीं कर पा रहे हो तो then we can work on it, right?
Actually, LRDA, after when I analyze LRDA questions, then बहुत सारे हो जाते हैं, लेकिन exam में पता नहीं गलत set.
Time pressure की वजह से, क्योंकि हाँ, अभी आप उसका regular section wise practice करने लगोगे ना, तो फिर वो आपको ऐसे लगेगा ही नहीं कि mock paper में भी आपको ऐसे लगेगा कि आप जैसे section test ही दे रहे हो. तो your mindset will be a completely in a different mode.
Exactly. Right?
So क्योंकि अभी आप खुद सोचो कि अब paper में mock paper में कर नहीं पा रहे हो, लेकिन बाहर आके सब कर रहे हो. So it's only the mindset जो आपको correct करना है. It's not the knowledge that you need to correct, right? You already have the knowledge, right? So you just need to go with the right strategy and right mindset. तो वो एक दिन में आएगा क्या? कोई नहीं आएगा, right? नहीं आएगा. उसके लिए practice चाहिए, right? To have a, you know, calming mind in the final paper, a fearless mind in the paper, this also need practice. It cannot come in one single day, right? So go for daily, on daily basis you need to practice all these things. All right. Tell me anything, any other doubts that you want to ask?
And nothing of specific sort, but if I watch your quants, this algebra and geometry videos, then it will be of great help, no, sir.
Yes, geometry I have covered comprehensively. In fact, there are more than 500. While I'm talking about 500 questions, I'm not taking coordinate geometry in it. Coordinate geometry have a separate set of 100 questions, which I'm taking currently in special classes. Right? Algebra have 500. Yes. Algebra classes have 500 questions. Right, and it also does not include my workshop questions, 100 workshop questions on algebra that I'm taking. So there's 10 workshops on algebra also. I think if you covered all this, there's nothing left. Okay, algebra, that the way I have taken, I have covered, you know, more than 14 topics in algebra. Every topic of algebra has been discussed separately. It's not that I'm discussing only quadratic and cubic and then that algebra is over. So I started from algebraic identities, expression, logarithm, everything, functions.
Everything covered.
Even sequence series pe total 70 around questions. And sari types ki series cover hai. Cover hai, sir, kuch cover.
Sorry, puchna tha sir, wo YouTube channel LRDA prep, I also watched that channel. So those videos are of great help. So wo sufficient in a sense. I'm watching your plus videos also.
Yeah, plus video and LRDA prep, yes. But my plan is to upload around, you know, 150 plus set on 150 very, very selective set on the channel before CAT. I guess I have uploaded till now around 30-35 set in 45 videos. So very soon, in this month, I'll be uploading 60 more videos. They are prepared. It's just the normal editing that I have to, that it has to go through. And yes, LRDA prep also will help you a lot in, you know, understanding various types of concepts. What I'm doing here, there is, कि मैं हर टॉपिक का वहाँ पे बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट डिस्कस कर रहा हूँ, आपको प्रैक्टिस सेट 150 के अराउंड मिल जाएंगे पूरे इट कवर कॉम्प्रिहेंसिवली वहां पे भी आपको काफी हेल्प मिलेगा
Okay, sir.
Tell me anything else you want to ask, Hemant?
No.
Okay, so, kuch bhi.
Strategy implement karunga, sir, uske baad I'll get back to you, sir.
Bilkul. Anytime, right? Let's see how your score improves. And let's meet after 2 or 3 more mocks. And let's see ki usme kya improvement aa raha hai, what are the weak areas, then we'll try to work upon again, right? Make sure that every mock paper that you are giving, you have a proper analysis on it. Note down your mistakes, okay? Work on the mistakes and then go to second mock. Aise bahut zyada number of mocks dene ka itna zarurat nahi hai. I have seen a lot of people with, you know, clearing CAT only with 10 mocks, right? Last year, one student from at Unacademy itself, Shweta Rai, she gave around 10 to 15 mocks. That's it. And she got 99.69% and she is currently in IIM Calcutta. So it's not that ki 50 mocks dena zaruri hai. Ho sakta hai. That depends ki aapka kya strength and weak area is time pair. Aapka kya position hai, right? But okay. So just make sure that every mock that you're sitting before going to the next mock, you do the corrections of your mistakes in the first mock. Otherwise, there's no point of moving to mock. Mock one ka analyze karke, mistakes ko note down karke, uspe kaam karke, then go to mock. With this strategy, if you go for even 10 to 15 mocks, I would say that will be sufficient. It's not ki 50 mocks dunga tabhi 99 aayega, aisa nahi hai, right?
Okay.
Time hai, do, definitely do. Agar time hai, to do. Koi problem nahi hai. But again, mock to mock improvement aapko dikhna chahiye. Aisa.
Right? Analysis bhi shayad ek issue hai sir. Analysis bhi utna time nahi de pata isliye shayad.
Analysis pe sabse in fact more important than giving 30 mocks, I would say it's analysis of 10 to 20 mocks. Analysis is more important. That will automatically improve your score. Okay. So do a proper analysis of your mock. Okay.
Okay, sir.
All right. We'll meet then again a month, right? And nice meeting you. I hope it helped. Right, the strategy.
Pleasure meeting you, sir. Pleasure. Main classes karta hu aapki.
Great. Okay, so join me there, right? It's for plus students, so you can join there, right? So we'll meet there. Okay, you can contact me there and I'll get
you. Okay, sir.
All right, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.